Hi, my name is Dan Wahlin with Interface Technical Training. I'd like to introduce the ASP.NET 4 Webforms Programming with Visual Studio course to you. If you're looking to move into Webforms and you've already taken a C# or a Visual Basic course, then this is a great course to help get you started. We're going to cover all the core pieces that you need to know in order to successfully build ASP.NET applications. So some of the things we'll talk about include the page class. How do you interact with it? Why do you care? And we'll talk about some of the key methods and properties that are available on it to help you as a developer. We'll also go into some of the more key aspects of any ASP.NET application, and that is binding data to controls. And we'll talk about several of the different controls out there, the list view, the grid view, even the more simple controls like the drop-down list. From there, we'll go into data source controls and cover some of the new controls that are available and talk about how you can even extend your queries and filter and sort and all that fun stuff with the query extender. From there, we'll go into some of the fun stuff, at least I think it is, when it comes to structuring your site, and that includes master pages and themes. You want to make your website consistent so that if my mom goes there or someone who's maybe not quite as technical, then we want to make it easy and consistent so they feel comfortable navigating between pages. Well, that's what master pages are for, and we'll talk about how to structure those and use those in your applications. From there, we'll move on to other topics used in ASP.NET, including security topics like membership and profiles, personalization data, in other words, and how you can store that. And we'll talk about a built-in way, something Microsoft provides out of the box you can use, or we'll even talk about how you can do custom databases for storing user credentials. A lot of good stuff there to cover that's very, very relevant to our technologies today. Nowadays, AJAX is really popular, and we don't want to always load the page over and over every time the user blinks or clicks, and that gets a little bit annoying. So we'll talk about ASP.NET AJAX techniques that you can apply, and we'll even introduce you to jQuery, which is a very, very popular open JavaScript library that allows you to very easily manipulate the document object model, show and hide things, even do animations, and really take your applications to the next level. And then finally, we'll introduce some real big productivity features such as ASP.NET dynamic data. If you've ever wanted to make admin tables in your database and make an app that can get into those easily, and I'm talking about things like lookup tables, maybe have states, customer data, things like that, then that actually takes a lot of time from a productivity standpoint to build from scratch. With dynamic data, you can do that literally in 5 to 10 minutes. And we'll talk about how to do that, how to extend that functionality and customize it. Then the last thing we'll do is introduce you to another ASP.NET technology called ASP.NET MVC, or Model View Controller. And we'll basically introduce you to controllers and actions and how those all integrate with views. So you can see we have a lot of good stuff we're going to talk about, really help you take your C# or VB skills to the next level so you can apply those to web technology. So I'll look forward to seeing you in class.